I'm sure you've read lists like this before. Everything to do in Cleveland this summer, articles are littered throughout my timeline. But I've decided to compile a list of some of my absolute favorite things to do in Cleveland that I'm thinking you have never heard of before. Each one of these is unique, underrated, and always a good time. Asterisk disclaimer, if you are going to attempt to go to some of these places, keep in mind that they are on private property. You need expressed consent of the property owner or manager before entry. 1. Abandoned underground subway system. Did you know Cleveland had an operational underground subway system similar to New York City for decades? The subway was closed in 1954, which means that it sits in quiet darkness beneath the city and has been untouched for over 60 years. Over the summer, the county's engineer office opens up the abandoned subway system and streetcar bridge for guided group tours or free self-guided tours. The entrance is located near the Hope Memorial Bridge and goes underneath the parts of downtown. It is eerie but very beautiful and antiquated inside. 2. Warplane Graveyard. About 40 minutes outside of Cleveland lays a cemetery of entirely different proportions. Walter Soplata gathered up an impressive collection of old World War II and on warplanes and has placed them in a woody reservation in Newberry, O. Currently, there are about 20 old airplanes rotting in the forest on private property, including a B-52, a Goodyear FG-1D, and other famous models. If you're a history nerd like me, this is a gold mine. 3. Dittrich Museum of Medical History. This museum is definitely not run-of-the-mill. If you have an interest in medicine, healthcare, human anatomy, you'll love it. If not, I'm sure you'll find something interesting about this unique place. Located on the Case Western Reserve campus, this museum offers very unique displays of medical oddities, contraception, and has era-themed doctor offices and hospital rooms to take you back in time. This is one of my favorite museums in Cleveland. 4. Warner and Swazi Observatory. Another great place for science buffs. But loved by people indifferent to astronomy as well. This place was built in the early 20th century and was donated to Case Western School of Applied Science in 1919. It was in full use as a space observatory for the school with 9.5-inch refractor and top-of-the-line Borel-Schmidt telescope. But as time passed and Cleveland rapidly urbanized, light and chemical pollution made the observatory no longer useful and the night sky could no longer be studied properly. In 1982, the observatory was abandoned and still sits empty on Taylor Road. Structurally beautiful and very unique inside, this is definitely a fun place to visit and explore. 5. Franklin's Castle. This is noted as Ohio's most haunted house. From suicides and murders at the home to Nazi seances to discovery of children's remains on the property, this place is a textbook example of what it takes to be a haunted house. Except this isn't a chilling seasonal Halloween attraction, this is the real deal. Evidence of ghosts at this location have been documented since the 50s. There are third-party groups that do tours of the property and you can always visit yourself. People say that you can still hear the ghostly screams coming from inside. But even if you're a skeptic, it has beautiful architecture and very in-depth Cleveland history. 6. Soldiers and Sailors Monument. Open for public tours throughout the summer, this monument's interior is extremely underrated and it has a very unique secret. Inside the monument lays access to dark stretches of secret underground pathways that trail beneath our city's famous public square. This monument also features a notoriously famous bronze sculpture referred to by natives as Kill. 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 Definitely check this one out and explore for yourself. 7. Cleveland's only suspension bridge. Located in Kingsbury Run, the famous section of the city that witnessed the terrible wrath of Cleveland's worst serial killer, the Torso Murderer, lays Cleveland's only suspension bridge for pedestrians. Overgrown and abandoned, it holds a remarkable and dark history with a beautiful design. This is a quick adventure that I thoroughly enjoyed. You can find this footbridge at E65th on Sideway Avenue. 8. The Shoot Tree. There are lots of stories that try to explain the Shoot Tree, but you can discover those on our own and pick whichever one you like the most. This extraordinary Shoot Tree is located within Cleveland's famous Lake View Cemetery. Lake View is worthy of its own day of exploration too. You can also visit the Hazarot Angel of Death, who cries black tears, and legend says she can bless or curse those who visit depending on the circumstance. 9. Autorama Drive-In. Most people have never been to an authentic drive-in like Autorama, but this one of my favorite things to do on any given summer night. Very relaxed setting, outside atmosphere, lots of childhood nostalgia and pretty great concessions. This place is a lot of fun and inexpensive. Pack up your car, gather your friends and go to the movies like they used to. This place is a local, family-owned business too and is located about 40 minutes outside the city. Or if you're feeling more adventurous, you can go visit one of Ohio's countless abandoned drive-in theaters, like the Leatherwood, Hawking Theater or the Linden Air. 10. Indian Point Park. There are lots of great hiking spots in and around Cleveland. This one is very solid though and has all of my favorite credentials. It's got a unique Ohioan history, a somewhat challenging path and a beautiful waterfall. This is a local favorite and it's only about 30 minutes from downtown. 11. Chippewa Lake Amusement Park. This one is getting demolished soon, according to my extensive internet research, so be sure to check it out this summer before it is gone. This is an abandoned, old-fashioned amusement park that lays rotting in the forest 45 minutes south of Cleveland. The park opened in 1878 and closed in 1978 after a successful career. Certainly spooky but very special and soon will no longer be with us. Remains of the rides still remain, including the Ferris wheel, a few roller coasters, and children's rides. 12. Cuyahoga Railroad. For a good price you can ride authentic trains on the old Cuyahoga Valley Railroad. It's a scenic trip with interesting history facts along the way and is certainly a fun time for anybody, especially younger kids. They also have Ales on the Rails events all summer long with local beer tasting on antique trains. That sounds pretty great to me. Cuyahoga Valley also features some great hiking in the area, if you didn't already know.